And we are going to start the tribute this morning with the class of 2000 from the PMS school. If you are here, then we have a little Watts and family with a tribute. Elsa Leek, his niece, the Brave Basketball Club, and the On the School Social Club, and family, and Dante Joseph. So those are the tributes that were this morning's service. So if you are here, PMS class 2000, could you please come forward to render your tribute? And if they're not here, you can help me just assist and say, they're not here, who are they? I don't know who they are. So we don't have a hold up as they come, we can always bring them along.
Christ alone. When the ocean rises and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over every flood. I will be still and know you. Find rest, my soul, in Christ alone. Know His power in quietness and trust. When the ocean rises and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you. When the ocean rises and thunders roar, I will soar with you above every storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you. I will be still and know you, our God.
In every storm, we know that there is our God. So family, find rest.
He only takes the best. God saw that he was getting tired, a cure was not to be. So he put his arms around him and whispered, "Come with me." With tearful eyes, we watched him suffer and saw him fade away. Although we loved him dearly, we could not make him stay. A golden heart stopped beating, hard working hands to rest. God broke our hearts to prove to us he only takes the best.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Well, I know I'm not a whole club and a basketball team, but unfortunately, I got to represent the guys from both settings. We were supposed to initially sing, but thank God we don't have to because that lady was really dope, so we can't follow that. But in everything small and great, give thanks. You know, I always say, in sorrow and joy, you have to give thanks, and the Lord is in control of everything. I really can't offer no words of where this goes, just from my own personal experiences with my dad. I could say the only thing for the family is just prayer and faith and just time, you know. People say it gets better with time, but honestly, it really don't. So I just say, just lean on each other, have someone that you can talk to in any event that you need to reach out to someone, because death is hard. I know people give you all these words of encouragement, but when you're in it personally, it's not really something that you want to hear a whole lot of. You just have to find your own feeling with you. But on behalf of the members of the Bridge Basketball Club and the On the School Social Club, we'd like to send our condolences and sympathy out to the family and just pray that God gives you the strength and time you need to heal and recover from your loss. Thank you.
I don't believe it. far, I don't believe it's probably this far, I don't believe he's probably this far.
I believe I should be grateful today that I can live to see my journey and keep your words of encouragement that will help me to push forward. And I say, young goodness, and I love you. I want to miss you a lot in the same. And people really appreciate that. You can never know which day is going to be yours. God is good.
Amen.
Stay blessed.
Thank you. Thank you.
everything to God.
you can read, so that at my funeral you can read my eulogy. So here I am. Emerson Carl Fitzroy Jarvis was born to Miss Blondina Barnes on Federation Road, Green Bay, and Miss Radford Jarvis of Cooks Hill on January 4th, 1981. He did not enter this world alone, as he was closely followed by his twin brother Edison. According to our mother, he was such a bouncing baby boy that the neighbors called him Bouncer on the very first time they saw him. A few months after his birth, he and Edison were blessed at the Green Moravian Church. When he was of age, our mother ensured that he attended Sunday school and church services, that he walked for confirmation and was a member of the junior choir. In fact, Emerson started attending the Green Bay Moravian Church preschool at the tender age of 2 years old. However, after the unfortunate closure of the schools of the church's preschool, my mother registered him at the Grace Green Preschool and Child Care Center, located just above the Green Bay Primary School. In 1986, at the age of 5, Emerson started his primary school education at St. Michael Primary School, of course, with his twin. A few years later, after the school relocated, my Auntie Janet, she worked on getting them transferred to Green Bay Primary School because they didn't want to walk all the way to East Bus Station to catch the bus to get to the new school location. And so they went to Green Bay Primary School, which was conveniently located just across the street. In 1993, Emerson was successful at the local Common Entrance Exam and moved on to the Princess Margaret Secondary School, where he completed his secondary education. He graduated in the year 2000. Emerson was very ambitious. He loved working and being independent. He did not want to depend on anyone at any time. As a matter of fact, even while he was attending secondary school, he worked part-time during summers and after school at several businesses to include the former Sandmer agencies, Food City Supermarket, and the Epicurean Supermarket, previously located at the Wood Center. After secondary school, he found permanent employment and worked at the Epicurean Supermarket for a few years. He later worked at the Luke's, the Beach Bar and Restaurant at Dickinson Bay, and eventually spent most of his working life at A.S. Bryden & Sons. Emerson's last place of employment were at the Carmichael's Restaurant at Sugar Ridge Resort and the Antigua Candle Factory. He left the employment to start his own rental car business, One Dan Car Rental. Emerson was very sociable and loved working in the service industry. During his days waiting tables and bartending, many guests and customers were attracted to his jovial personality and loving smile. He was impeccable at the customer service as a customer service representative. Further, while working at Carmichael's, he was mentioned in a guest review published on TripAdvisor.com. Though his name was erroneously spelled with one M, that didn't bother him. As known to many of us sitting here today, Emerson was also an avid sports enthusiast and enjoyed playing football with his alma mater, the Princess Margaret Secondary School. He also loved basketball and played for the Braves Basketball Club as a starting player in the second and third divisions of the National Basketball League. He considered three-point shooting his specialty and saw himself second only to Reggie Miller, the greatest three-point shooter in the U.S. NBA at the time, and therefore he dubbed himself Reggie Miller. He also participated in several of the community's Easter Classic and Grace Green League in both sports. On one occasion, he participated in track and field at the Easter Classic. He placed fourth among the competitors, but based on how excited he was when he told the story over and over and over again, you would have gotten the impression that he actually won, or at least he came very close to winning, but no. As far as he was concerned, he was a winner. Pertaining to sports, his love of football and those of us who know him know that he was a huge fan of the Chelsea Football Club in the English Premier League. In fact, you would often hear him shout, "Come on, Chelsea," when he was driving to the community and would stop to brag to his friends and fellow football fans about each victory and how their team was in trouble for the game on Sunday. Emerson enjoyed his time with his cousins and friends from the neighborhood. He would invite them over at the house to play video games. There was hardly ever a quiet moment. I remember something about Negus and Eddie and Emerson Mahaja when they would play, whenever it was like a comeback game, you know, one-on-one fighting. And whenever one of them would win, they would look at the other and say, "You can't bang me, it just have a tackle." I love that. Okay. He also liked making kites during the kite season. He would often hike his kite, tie it, and go to work. A few hours later, one of his friends from the neighborhood would run into the yard, take it down, and put it on the gallery because the police were driving around cutting them down. He did the same for others. He also loved and enjoyed music. During earlier years after leaving school, he traveled with his friends to the Creole Fest in Dominica and St. Kitts and Nevis Music Festival. At some point, Emerson bought a whole sound system and would go about being the best DJ in Antigua. He would disturb the neighborhood playing his favorite song. Emerson had a passion for sports cars, especially Honda. This passion led him to buying and changing vehicles very often. One time I told him, "You change vehicles faster than some people change cars." And he spent many nights at the local racetrack embracing his passion and watching and even participating in events. He shared this love of cars with his son, Javon, and he took Javon with him oftentimes to the racetrack, and also while servicing his cars, he had Javon with him. So Javon probably learned a lot, and he could probably service the car for you, but don't ask him because we charge. At the Wadadley Honda Day event in 2011 at the Severian Richards Stadium, he actually won the People's Choice Trophy and the plaque for the best DC sizing show. He came home that night and told me to make a spot for his trophy at Mommy's cabinet. Further, he made it clear to everyone in the house that his trophy was better than all of our academic and performance trophies combined because it was the biggest and therefore it was the best one. As a person, Emerson was well-loved and popular amongst his peers and with people wherever he went. He had a lot of friends. Driving with him on Federation Road and up to King George was like driving in a motorcade. Every other second, he saw someone he knew or someone called out to him, and he honked his horn repeatedly as he drove by. He would hold the steering wheel with one hand and he would raise the other hand out the window, acknowledging everyone. As previously mentioned, he worked from a young age to afford the things he wanted. One of those things was his wardrobe. Emerson was a colorful dresser. He wore shirts with loud colors and eccentric patterns and bought the authentic Timberlands and Nikes. However, at a later point in his life, he changed from wearing colorful patterns to just slippers, shorts, and his signature white t-shirt. And this earned him the moniker Uncle White Shirt. Apart from Edison, his twin, he had four other brothers, Lloyd, Carl, Rasheen, and Carson. He had three sisters, Cleo, Quinzel, and myself, Quincy. But if any of y'all want to sit down and debate it, we can. I am his favorite. He showed great love and affection to his nieces and nephews. He was the fun uncle. He had no biological children of his own, but he adopted a son, Javon Richards, whom he nurtured and cared for to his dying day. In his mid-20s, Emerson was diagnosed with diabetes, and in 2021, he began to experience the complications of the disease. He was hospitalized, he lost three toes on his left foot, secondary to an infection, he experienced kidney failure and began dialysis. His life changed drastically. He tried his very best to remain independent during this medical difficulty by working as a taxi driver. However, this was short-lived and became too difficult. As someone who had worked to be independent since the age of 14 or 15 years old, to becoming dependent on others, this was a frustrating time for him. But his voice remained strong, and he tried to keep a positive outlook on life. On the 2nd of August, 2022, he passed away quietly at his home in Hatton.
He will be missed daily by all of us who had an opportunity to know him during the years of his early sojourn. We will miss his pearly white teeth, his jokes, and his caring personality. We are grateful for and have enjoyed all the many wonderful years spent with Emerson when he was at the best, and also have a deep appreciation for every moment that we spend visiting with him during his quiet experience of illness. My entire family would like to express our deepest and sincere thanks to everyone who was a part of Emerson's life, and the many persons who have offered prayers, condolences, and have shown kindness during this time of bereavement, and who now joins us in celebrating his life and to mourn his passing. My dear brother, take your rest in the arms of Jesus. You will forever be in our hearts, and your time with us will be etched in our daily memories. We love you eternally. We live with the hope that we will all meet again and be reunited in the great beyond.
Taken from Psalm 91, verses 1 through 16. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler, and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that fleeth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noon on day. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold, and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, the habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear them up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample on the feet. Because he hath set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him, and shew him my salvation. This is the word of God.
Good morning, church. Second reading. The second reading will be taken from John 14, 1 to 6. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. This is the word of the Lord.
Meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. I remember hearing the story about three men. An Italian, a Frenchman, and a Jew. What a table, I say, oh boy. You think that's trouble? No, those three men, they were condemned to die. And as they were about to face execution, the executors came by and told them that they all had the choice or the right to a final meal. And so they went to the Frenchman, they asked him what he wanted as a final meal. He told them that he wanted some good French wine and some French bread. And so they gave that to him, and he ate, and he was executed. And then they came to the Italian man. They asked him what he wanted as his final meal. He said, I wanted some pasta. They gave him his pasta, he ate it, and then they executed him. Now it was the Jews turned. They came to him. They asked him what was his choice of meal, what he wanted as a final meal. He said he just wanted a big bowl of strawberries. His executor said, strawberries? You're kidding me. Strawberries, they are not even in season now. The man said, so, I'll wait. My friends, we can beat the systems, but not God's system. The fact is, death is a reality that none of us can escape. I hear how smart and intelligent and how ambitious our brother was, Emerson, but he could not have escaped death. I say this to bring all here and all in the hearing of my voice to the reality that Emerson is no longer with us. We need to accept it. It is important. He is dead. He is no longer with us. But I have come here today with a message of hope. I've come to say to you here and to all in the hearing of my voice that there is hope in Jesus. Tell somebody to your left and to your right, there is hope in Jesus. Come on, say it. There is hope in Jesus. Jesus says in John's Gospel, the second reading that would have been read, he said, let not your heart be troubled. John chapter 14. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, so that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not where thou goest. How can we know the way? Jesus said unto him in verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto me, unto the Father, but by me. Let not your heart be troubled. Trouble, my friends, means difficulty or problems or challenges. People would tell you that they had trouble finding the final destination. They had trouble finding a particular address. It could also mean public disorder or public unrest. Trouble, one who is troubled is not settled. One who is troubled is not at peace. And so Jesus made the point that in this world there will be trouble. You will have tribulation, you will have trouble. But do not fear, do not be afraid, for I have overcome the world. And as I look at this text, I see a predicament. As I look at this text, I see not just a predicament, but I see a prescription. And as I look at this text, John 14, 1 to 6, I see not just a predicament, not just a prescription, but I see a promise. I see a predicament. The predicament is the trouble that we have to face in this life. No one can escape trouble in this world. Ye shall have trouble and tribulation, Jesus says. Many things cause trouble in this world, from strange ideologies. We hear of all sorts of ideologies these days. And you know some of them, or most of them. A famous one has to do with the fight for equality among lay and lesbians. The LGBT movement. Lesbian, gay, bisexual, transsexual. And this list continues. You have a longer list. I'm still of the belief that marriage is between a man and a woman. Amen. You may not talk to me after this message, but that's fine. I'll be all right. strange ideologies. We live in a world that is full of trouble, a world that is being plagued by pandemics of all sorts. We used to hear of chikungunya. We used to hear of malaria and other stuff. And now COVID-19, the famous COVID-19 pandemic, has taken over the world. And now we move on from COVID-19 to what? Monkeypox? Whatever other pox is coming. We live in a world that is full of trouble. We live in a world where we no longer hear of wars and of rumors of wars. We are living in wars. We may not be living literally in wars here, but some people are in wars with each other. In war, they are in war with their siblings, with their family members, over trivial things, petty things, temporal things. They are in war over some money that somebody died and left behind, over a house, over a car, over some land title. We are in war with each other. Oh, I'm here today to say to you that there is hope in Jesus, that one day all these things shall cease. The war going on now between Russia, Russia and Ukraine is affecting the entire world, sending gas prices up like crazy. It used to take 150 to 160 to fill my tank. Now it's $235, $240 to fill it up. The most prominent trouble that we face in this world is sin. Sin is our problem. Sin is the problem of the world. Sin has affected and continues to affect every one of us. We believe in the original sin, in the fact that our first parents, Adam and Eve, were created in a state of innocency and happiness. But because of their disobedience, they have fallen out of grace with God. They have sinned, and as a result, we all have become sinners, totally depraved and exposed to the wrath of God, exposed to the penalty of sin, even death. For the wages of sin is death. We read from Romans 6:23. Sin is our problem. Sin is what causes us trouble. But thank God, in this text, we see not just a predicament, we see a prescription. And this prescription is Jesus. It says, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. That is Jesus speaking. I said the solution to the problem of sin, the solution to the predicament of sin, the solution to the problems of this world is Jesus. The solution is not religion. The solution is not a political party. The solution is not some financial institution. The solution is not to be found in any social club that we may belong. My friends, the solution is found in Jesus. Jesus is the one who can answer all our needs. Christ is the answer to my need. The songwriter says, Christ is the answer. He is my friend indeed. Problems of life, my spirit may assail. With Christ, my Savior, I shall never fail. For Christ is the answer to my need. In the midst of our trouble, it is Christ who will give us peace. He said to the disciples and to us today, even as recorded in John chapter 14, verse 27, peace I leave with you, my peace I give with you, I live with you, I give unto you, not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I am here to say that the problem to our predicament, the problem to the predicament of sin, is Jesus Christ. Christ came to save us from the penalty of sin, even death. Many people promote religion. Many people promote customs and traditions. But as I said, Jesus is is the answer to the problem of sin. For we read from Acts 4 verse 12, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. The problem, the solution to our trouble is not in any religion. It's not simply in Christianity, for you may have many Christians who are going to hell. Should I say so-called Christians? I believe the problem, the solution to the world is not religion. I believe there could be, some people don't agree with me, but I'm more so of a liberal Christian. I believe that there could be Hindus who are going to heaven. I believe that there could be Muslims who are going to heaven. Who am I? For when Jesus says, oh, the sheep that I have are not from this fold. I believe while the literal meaning has to do with Jesus differentiating between the Jews and the Gentiles, I believe it is wider than this. Nobody knows who really will be saved and who will not be saved. So I am here to commend Jesus to you as a Christian, to tell you the answer is not in religion. Whether you are Methodist, a Pentecostal, a Baptist, a Seventh-day Adventist, a Catholic, a Salvationist, I am here to say religion will not save anyone. For it's not everyone that said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. The answer to sin is Jesus. It is not Buddha. It is not Joseph Smith. It is not Mohammed. It is not Haile Selassie. But the answer is Jesus. On Christ, the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. As I look at this text, I see not just a predicament. I see not just a prescription, but I see a promise. Jesus says, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. This is a promise. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. I will come again. These words came from Jesus' own mouth. I will come again and receive you unto myself, so that where I am, there ye may be also. Jesus is God. Jesus is not a man that he should lie. He's not like us who promise and do not keep our promises. Your friends will promise to be there for you, and then when you find yourself in real trouble, they are nowhere to be found. When they could help you, they are nowhere to be found. They could give you that loan that would save your life, or save your reputation, and they do not. They come short. Your friends would promise to visit you when you are sick, and you never see them. You find yourself in prison, and they are nowhere to be found. You have some friends in high places who promise you some job, but they never deliver. You have some friends sitting on some boards where you are being condemned. They could defend you, but they remain quiet. They don't say a word. But Jesus is not like that. But God, yes, is yes, and his no, is no. He will keep his word. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is God. He came. There was a promise that we would have come and be born for lost to die for lost humanity. He came and was born in a manger. The promise that he would die, yes, he died. There was a promise that he would rise from the dead. Yes, he rose from the dead. And he ascended into the heavens. And he's now seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty, interceding for you and for me, and now waiting for a word from the Father to come back for his own. I am here to say, take courage, my friends. In spite of your troubles, in spite of what you may be going through, there is hope in Jesus. We live in a world that has no hope, and so people are killing themselves. The suicide rate is going up all over the world, especially among young people. But I'm here to say that there is hope in Jesus. People do not know what to do. People are living from paycheck to paycheck. They do not know where the money is going to come from to pay the bills. But I'm here to tell you that there is hope in Jesus. Some people are depending on their guns for protection. But I'm here to say that your real protection is in Jesus. There is hope in Jesus. Paul says, if it is in this life alone that we have hope, then we are of all men, of all persons, all miserables. I am glad that the greatest hope of all is the hope of eternal life. And here it is in the promise. I go to prepare a place for you. And you can find this promise only in Jesus. I am the way, the truth, and the life, he says. And no one cometh unto the Father but by me. Heaven is my hope. I have the hope that this life is not all there is. I believe there is hope. There is life after death. There is life in Jesus. If you believe, my friends, if you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life, and have accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior, as I understand my brother Emerson did, one day you shall be reunited with him. One day you shall see your brother again. One day you shall see your uncle again, your nephew, your child again. I am here to say that this hope can be yours, the hope of eternal life. This promise of eternal life can be yours if you only accept Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life. I look forward to that day when I shall leave behind this world of trouble. I look forward to that day when I will be joining the saints in heaven and laughing at the world and saying, goodbye world, I stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, I stay no longer with you, but I have made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I look forward to walking on streets of gold. I will look forward to sitting beside the elders and singing, it soon be done, my troubles and trials. When I get home on the other side, I'm going to shake my hand with the elders and tell my people good morning. I'm going to sit down beside my Jesus and sit down beside him, not just for a little while, but for a long while, in his presence, in heaven, where there will be no need for the moon to shine by night or the sun by day. For we shall be, I shall be, in his presence. His Shekinah glory will be enough for me. For in his presence, there is fullness of joy, and at his right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. I look forward to living this world of trouble and be with my Jesus, where there will be no more headache, no more heartache, no more cancer, no more diabetes, no more hypertension, no more chikungunya, no more hunger, no more discrimination, but it shall be peace and joy unspeakable and full of glory. Come on, and remember in this text, there is not just a predicament, but there is also a prescription, and even more so, there is a promise. It is a promise of eternal life, for indeed, there is hope in Jesus. May Almighty God bless us all, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And the church says, hallelujah, give him praise in the house. Hallelujah. The Lamb of God. Please stand as we continue in prayer. Let us continue in prayer. Lord, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. By your human birth, by your obedience and faithfulness, by your prayers and tears, by your agony and passion, by your dying words, by your reconciling death, by your rest in the grave, by your triumphant resurrection, by your abiding presence. Let us sing the Lord's Prayer together. We may not hold hands unless you know the person. We're still in a pandemic, but we sing the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Merciful God, the refuge and strength of those who put their trust in you, we thank you for the multitude no one can number, whom you have received into your eternal joy. We praise you that you have forgiven them all their sins, and that they dwell with you beyond evil and sorrow forever. We thank you also for all to whom amid the trials of this mortal life, you give the faith that overcomes the world, who have peace in you and rejoice in hope of your glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal God, before whose face the generations rise and pass away, we bless and praise your name for all who have departed this life in faith, especially for Emerson, K. F. Jarvis, for all your kindness to him throughout his earthly life, we give you thanks. We thank you that for him, all sickness and sorrow are ended, and that death itself is past. Almighty God, may we, inspired by the example of your saints, run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, so that when this mortal life is ended, we may be gathered with those whom we have loved in the kingdom of your glory, where there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Father of mercies and God of all comfort, you make nothing in vain and love all that you have made. Look in tender mercy on your people in their loss. Enable them to find in you their refuge and their strength, a very present help in trouble. We pray for your peace and comfort upon the hearts of the immediate family members. Blondina, Barnes, mother, Bradford, Jarvis, father, and other siblings, Ederson, Carl, Winsel, Quincy, and others. We pray that you will sustain them and deliver them from bitterness, despair, and doubt of your love. Comfort them in their sadness. Uphold them with your strong love. Help them to face the future without fear, knowing that they and all whom they love are in your hands, and that nothing, not even death itself, can separate any one of us from your love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, our Father, by whom we are led through the changes of time to the rest and blessedness of eternity, be near us to comfort and uphold. Make us to know that your people are precious in your sight, and that they live evermore with you. As we thank you for Emerson K.F. Jarvis, whose life we shared, may we trust you at this time of parting. O God, give us of your strength, that we may this time, at this time of parting, God, give us strength, that we may take up our lives more bravely and seek to be more faithful in duty and more loving and helpful to others, following those who are no longer with us here on earth. And may we in our turn find in your great mercy the perfect and unending rest of God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us commend Emerson K.F. Francis, Jarvis, to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your power you gave us life, and in your love you have given us new life in Jesus Christ. We entrust Emerson K.F. Jarvis to your merciful keeping, in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again, that we might enjoy eternal life. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with us all, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Thank you.
Set.
Everybody's here? Thank you.
us continue with the service of committal. Jesus said, set your troubled hearts at rest. Trust in God always. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you. We know that when our earthly frame is destroyed, we possess a building provided by God, eternal and in heaven. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. All who have faith in me shall live, even though they die. No one who lives and has faith in me shall ever die. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? Thanks be to God who gives the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. We have now entrusted Emerson K.F. Jarvis to God's merciful keeping, and we now commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Father of all, we pray to you for those whom we love but see no longer. Grant them your peace. Let light perpetual shine upon them. And in your loving wisdom and almighty power, work in them the good purpose of your perfect will through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously with all who mourn, that casting every care upon you, they may know the consolation of your love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, support us all the day long of this earthly life until the shadows lengthen and evening comes, the busy world is hushed, the fever of life over, and our work done. Then, O Lord, in your mercy, grant us and those we love safe lodging, holy rest, and peace at the last through our Lord Jesus Christ. Rejoicing in the communion of saints, we thank you for all your servants who have departed in the faith, the great cloud of witnesses by whom we are encompassed, who in every age have loved you in life and continued faithful unto death, especially those most dear to our own hearts. Give us grace with them to follow you, and bring us at the last to those things which eye hath not seen nor ear heard, which you have prepared for them that love you. We continue. I'm not seeing any graveside hymn, but we will sing some probably familiar ones. I will track the words. We'll begin with "When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more." Is there a choir?
Emerson, last chance, boy. Emerson.
Choir. When the roll.
And the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. When the saints of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll. Resurrection share. When his chosen one shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll,
when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll. Yonder. When the road is full of yonder. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. And when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When we all get to heaven, sing the wondrous love of Jesus.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
Let us then be true and faithful.
Let us then be true and faithful.
Just in serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory. Will the toys of life repay? Oh, when we all are dead to heaven. What a day. God will be here
when we all
Jesus will sing and shout the victory. Onward to the Christ before us.
Onward to the Christ before us.
When we all
get to heaven,
what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us again.
Onward to the prize before us.
Soon his beauty will be home. Soon the pearly gates will open.
We
shall tread the streets of gold.
When we all
get to heaven, what a day
of rejoicing that will be.
When we all
see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
When we all
get
to heaven, heaven.
What a day of rejoicing at the
door. When we all see Jesus, we sing and shout the victory. When we all,
step to heaven.
Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Farther along, tempted and tried, we're up made to wander.
Tempted and tried, we're up made to wander.
Why it should be Jesus coming in glory.
When we see Jesus coming in glory.
When he comes from his home in the sky.
When he comes from his home in the sky.
Then we shall meet him in that bright mansion. We'll understand it. Father along,
Father along, will know all about.
Father along,
Father along, will understand why.
Share
up my brother,
live in the sun. We'll understand it. Father along,
Father along,
we'll know all about it.
Father along,
we'll understand why. Cherub, cherub, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it. All by and by.
mighty host advancing. Satan living on. Mighty ones around us falling. Courage almost gone. See the glorious banner waving. Hear the trumpet blow. In our leader's name we triumph over every foe. Hold the fort, for I am coming. Jesus, ignite still with the answer back to heaven by thy grace. First, unlong the battle wages. But our help is near. Onward comes our great commander. Cheer, my comrades, cheer. Hold the fort, hold the fort, for I am coming. Jesus, signal, stairs with the answer back to heaven. By thy grace we will. Hold the fort, hold the fort, for I am coming. Jesus, signal, stairs with the answer, with the answer.
Beautiful city.
On when my frail tent hair is full, mine eye shall its glory behold. In that city. Bright city.
In that bright city. A mansion above on a throne. Now I am waiting and running for the white city, that soon coming.
No sin in our law is allowed in that city. On nothing defiling or mean. No pain or no sickness can enter. No creep on the doorknob is seen. Earth's sorrows and cares are forgotten. No temper is there to annoy. No parting words ever spoken. There's nothing to hurt or destroy. In that bright city, early white city of a mansion, I have
Anacron, now I am watching, waiting for the white city that's soon coming down. No heartaches are known in that city. No tears ever moist in the eyes. There is no disappointment in heaven. No envy and strife in the sky. The saints are all sanctified, holy. They live in sweet harmony there. My heart is now set on that city. And someday its blessing I'll share. That white city, in that white city, early white city, oh, you have a mansion, a hope on a crown, while I am watching, waiting for that white city. That soon coming down. My loved ones are gathering yonder. My friends too are passing away. And soon I shall join the bright number and dwell in eternity. Safe now in glory.
Righteousness.
said, he lives. In death's dark, yet will I fear no ill, for thou art with me on thy rod, and staff me comfort still. He lives,
he lives,
I know he lives. I retain my lips, he lives within my table thou hast furnished, my table thou hast furnished, in presence of my foes, my head thou dost with oil anoint, and my cup overflows. He lives. I know that my Redeemer lives. He lives within my heart. Goodness and mercy,
goodness and mercy,
all my life shall surely follow me, and in God's house forevermore. My dwelling place shall be. He lives. I know that my Redeemer lives. He lives within my heart. Goodness and mercy all my life shall surely follow me, and in God's house forever my dwelling place. He lives.
I know that my Redeemer lives in me.
He lives. My heart, he lives.
Oh,
I know that my Redeemer lives, he lives within my heart. No grave can keep my body down. No faith can keep my body down. When the trumpet on the dead in Christ, no faith. Sing it again, no faith.
No faith can keep my body down.
No faith can keep my body down. And the trumpet, on the dead in Christ, faith, no grave. Sing it again, no grave.
No grave
can keep my. On the trumpet, on the dead in Christ, no grave.
Finish. No, soon.
One more time, no grave. No grave can
keep my body down.
No grave can keep my body down. On the trumpet, on the trumpet. No grave. Just the trumpet now, go ahead. Join in.
again for a final time. No grave, no grave can jump up. When the trumpet and the dead it dies, no grave, no grave. Another time, no grave, no grave. Oh, no grave. When the trumpet shall sound.
Amen.
Amen.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We ask the
image. Very loud, very loud.
Repeat that again. This song.
Yeah, the sing loud, very loud.
Okay, he's asking for one verse.
King up, last one. It is well.
It is well. It is well with my soul. With my soul. It is well. With my
Amen, amen, amen. I was almost in trouble in the church. I did not acknowledge the former Prime Minister Baldwin Spencer. But he reminded me of his presence here. Eh? He's qualified to join my choir. I heard him singing soprano and bass and all. And this gentleman, this is Joseph? Oh, the mass. I'm not sure. Oh, okay, great, great. Great to have you here with us. Amen. We know, we acknowledge your presence here, sir. We ask the immediate family members to come forward with their wreath. Come forth while the instrument plays. Nearer to thee.
Put over the heart.
Darkness be over me.
I
rest a stone.
Yet in my dream I feel.
Yet in my dream I'd be nearer, nearer, my God, to thee. Nearer, my God, to thee. Nearer to thee. Okay, close friends now and family members can come. Other family members and close friends, you can now come with your way. Joyful way. Oh, if on joyful way, cleaving the sky, sun, moon, and stars forgot, upward I fly. Still, all my song shall be nearer, my God, to thee. My song shall be still. My song shall be nearer, my God, to thee, nearer to thee. Thank you for your support to the family. We pray that you will continue to hold them, to keep them in your thoughts and prayers. And remember, as we leave this place, this service was not about Emerson. It is about us, the living. The question is, are we ready for such a time as this? It is my prayer, when the Lord shall return, we all shall be ready. And now receive the benediction. May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen and amen. Enjoy the rest of your day in the Lord. Still all my song shall be nearer. God bless you all. Thank you. Nearer, my God, to thee.
All of my friends who were here yesterday as well.
All right, everybody, take care. Take care.
Songbirds that sang in the dale seem to sing.
Prince,
on whom